We're coming to you live from Detroit Rock City at Gord Field, where it's an absolute free-for-all.
The stakes are high, and so am I.
It's in the air tonight, Grim.
Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Snuffle Thrills take on the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. The paddy wagons in the parking lots are full, the familiar scent of bodily fluids in the air, and the men's room is both flooding and on fire. And that means MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Man, last week some mutant let out a lava blast in one of the stalls in the men's room. Place went up like an oil rig. Flames and explosions. Water shooting out of where the toilets were. I electrocuted myself using the electric hand dryer. I wish they had paper towels at least as an option.
When defensive players go berserk, they've been known to rip the... Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
He scores! He earned those points on the heels of an epic run.
Don't call things epic, Grim. Kids aren't going to think you're cool no matter what you do.
Junior, I don't want kids to think I'm cool. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. For a first down. See if they can get something going here. First down and 5. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Bring up 2nd and 1. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company.
Devastating hit knocked the ball loose. First and 10. Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and five. First and ten. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done.
Yeah, man, I was cheating on him now.
Chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and ten. They're taking what the defense has given them. That's a 4-yard gain on the reception.
Hey, less than a wipe with a headache.
Second down and six. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Third down and six. And a hard run there picks up the first down. First and ten. Touchdown! And he rumbles that one into the end zone. Nicely done!
I can't run like that unless it's coupon night at Taco Hell. He has better footwork though than me on account of not clenching his kicks, though.
Nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. First and ten.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and long. Oh, great play! He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks.
Very smart. move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and ten.
It looks like the defense handed a shrinking pill.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. First down and one. The teams are all tied up at the end of quarter one. We'll be right back. First down and one. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. And that'll bring up second and one. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and ten. That's a catch for a 10-yard gain. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. I hope you covered your ears, Bricks, because that was a Sonic Blast dirty trick. Oh, what a punishing hit that was! And that's how you make a gut. And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appears to be cheating. He's just making shit up. Second down and 10. And they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and ten. And the quarterback is down.
Zoom in on his face. I want to see if the little bastard's crying.
Second down and more than the QB would like. And the defense holds that pass play to only 2 yards. Third down and, well, good luck. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense just blew up a player who thought he was going to score. Oh, that hot potato dirty trick gets him every time. And it's first and ten. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10. And that is caught for a first down. First down and 6. Kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. The defense called a sticky ball dirty trick, and the quarterback is in a shitload of trouble.
He's trying to throw the ball, Grim, but it keeps coming past to him.
Second down and a lot. Comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. Third down and 9. Oh, with the punishing hit. Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid. The quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver. Now, just when I thought only noobs would go for it on fourth for no real reason, they convert. But did they just get really lucky? Stay tuned. Two minutes remain in the half.
Wait! I gotta take a dump!
And it's first and 10. Call a timeout to stop the clock. Second down in a very lot. That's about a 3-yard pickup. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
Third down and 10. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Get the ball, asshole.
Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And the punter has one job to do, and that's punt the ball. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. First and 10. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And that'll be second down and 4. last time out. The D has to either break the clock or the offense if they want to win.
Hey, as long as something gets broke, right?
Well, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Nice punt. Should move them back. Nice catch. And he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. Let's see if he beats the odds. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
It's a tie game at the end of quarter 2. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, during the half, can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
The teams line up for the second half kickoff, deadlocked in a tie game. Bricks, there is nothing worse than a tie game.
I'm going to disagree. I'm going to say entire iron in your face.
Well, that's a good point. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Second down and 6. Third down, and the punter is warming up. This dirty trick. The quarterback unleashes. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he's got a chance for a good return here. Hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
He rifled that one in there, and they come up with 10 yards on the play. Second down and inches. Trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's first and 10. Simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And that pass finds its target. A pickup of 6 yards on the play. Down and 8. extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and 5. Down and, well, good luck. Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10.
I had this guy on my fantasy team.
And this ref is definitely on the take. That was a bogus penalty. And this is a first and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Down in a mile. The way to get the sticks moving, he picks up 5 on that play. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. Now, I'm not sure who he was throwing to on that play. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. He's got the ball now, and he's going to try and...
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
And it's first and 10. Oh, mama, he just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head...
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And that's a nice run for a first down. That's the end of 3, and it's anyone's game. Hang on tight, the fourth quarter is about to begin. And it's first and 10. Thank you. Second down in a very lot. Third down and long.
Hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
He had it for a second there. Second down and 10. Give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. Great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. Third and 2. Man, these guys have metal balls. They're going to try to pick up the first down here.
Do they jingle when they run?
They clank you.
The runner pulls out a chainsaw. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Remember, folks, in the NFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback, just like that. Second down and long. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Third down, and the punter is warming up. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. First down and 9. That's a 6-yard gain on that catch. Second and 3. Oh, great throw! Great catch! And then put 6 points on the board!
The defense can do anything to stop a throw. That's good,
man! You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Second down and 10. Well, fee-fi-fo-fum.
They're not finishing that joke, Grim.
And they pick up 9 with that catch.
Not enough for first, but still nice game.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Game and pick up the first. Nicely done. And it's 1st and 10. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have 2 left. And it's 1st and 10. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
Second down and a lot. And they're picking up chunks of yards now. Nice reception for 10 yards.
And timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim. You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Nicely done for a 1st down. First and 2. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
He zings it in there for a 4-yard gain. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. So the Motor City Maniacs get their asses handed to them here at home. You can smell the Molotov cocktails in the air.
Oh, that's my rubber foot again. Get caught in the space here. Please, ow!
They battled hard, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana-choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful.
Yeah, man, I was hitting them out.
Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Eagle SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.